No, no, we had Amy Adams and Helen Hunt. They put Helen Hunt
Helen
in support.
Hunt. Okay, okay, that makes
and
sense.
Supporting,
makes
I know, and she's not supporting.
I'm looking forward to seeing Sessions. That comes out this weekend.
I loved it. I don't know anything about heterosexual sex, but by the time I finished that movie, I did. I had more than I ever wanted to know.
So I can finally learn the proper.
Right. I didn't know what a landing strip was, but you'll find out anyway. Helen Hunt is more nude in this movie than any actress in the history of cinema, and all parts of her are in close up.
Oh, really? Okay.
Often, or from time to time.
Oh, wow. That's kind of.
Because it's about a man in an iron lung who is completely paralyzed except for one part of him.
Just guess which one.
And he wants to have sex before he dies, so he hires a sex surrogate. So.
It was a big hit at Sundance.
And Fox Searchlight is so nervous about that and so nervous about Beasts of the Southern Wild that they decided to release Hitchcock. On Thanksgiving, and the trailer just dropped. Have you seen the trailer?
I haven't seen the trailer. How does
hilarious.
It look?
Hilarious.
Is it?
And Helen Mirren just wipes the floor.
Really?
Wife.
Yeah, I was wondering.
She's like a fiery redhead, and he's the henpecked husband all of a sudden.
I was wondering why they decided to release it this year. I figured because isn't there the HBO movie with Naomi Watts that's coming out about?
No, it's about Sienna Miller, and it's coming out next week. Yes.
Girl. So I figured maybe they want to just kind of jump on that bandwagon.
No,
they
want to push Sir Anthony Hopkins playing Sir Alfred Hitchcock, he's very funny too.
So does that mean that they're not going to be pushing Beasts or Sessions as much?
Hey,
I don't know.
Where'd you get that idea? They're so nervous about
it. Messenger.
They're pushing Hitchcock into the Oscars, and Helen. The trailer they just released looks like both of them could be nominated. The best actress, the best actor thing is so crowded.
Joaquin.
And Daniel Day-Lewis. If you see the Sessions,
That's the thing. John Hawks is very well respected in Hollywood. I mean, he's one of those journeyman actors. I mean, he's done everything from Deadwood to Winter Bone. I mean, he's been nominated before.
And he doesn't move. Only
Head. And I mean, I worked for Daniel Day-Lewis with My Left Foot, so. I
watched the Sessions because of the incredible amount of landing strips in it.
I think you'll have a lot of people that'll love The Master, but a lot of people will hate it, as opposed to Sessions, where you have some people that will love it and some people will just kind of like, oh yeah, it was good. And I think that might be able to propel John Hawks over Joaquin Phoenix. You never know. I mean, it's still very early.
Unless Sir Anthony Hopkins gets in, or
I don't know. I mean, I think I could see it as very, very much like My Week with Marilyn last year, where I mean, perhaps he'll get nominated. But as you say, I mean, the trailer seems like it's very comedic, so it might be too light for Oscars. It might be too light for the Oscars. I mean, that was kind of what people said about My Week with Marilyn last year, was that it was kind of light and frothy. Although I love the film, I really enjoyed
the making of Psycho with Scarlett Johansson in the shower scene. I think they'll watch this screener. And it's coming out on Thanksgiving. And
I think so, yeah.
Helen is terrific in it.
Is she?
And she may be knocking people out of the best actress category.
So best actress, we have Helen Mirren. We have the girl from Beasts of the Southern Wild.
Provenzani Hall. Wallace has been on my show.
I'm so impressed that you know how to remember or how to pronounce
it. I may say it over and over
again. Next thing you know, you'll be able to pronounce Anna Karenina properly.
Yeah, right. Anna Karenina. I hope Keira Knightley gets in. I hope Marion Cotillard gets in. You know what also I just saw at the New York Film Festival, is at Toronto too, Amour.
Oh, right. Yeah, you were telling me you were going to see that.
You know about that film? It's about
the elderly couple, right? Yeah.
Facing, they should have called it La Mort because it's really about death.
Yeah, yeah.
And in it, the woman in the couple, the French actress Emmanuelle Riva from Hiroshima Mon Amour, when she was a beautiful young girl, is playing the woman who gets a stroke.
Oh, fantastic.
A series of strokes.
Yeah.
Strokes. And it plays all the levels of that condition, and it breaks your heart. You know,
I probably would see that as the front runner for best foreign film, I guess. Is that what?
Except
is that France?
Harvey got France.
Oh,
to
oh,
put
you're right.
The
Intouchables or Untouchables, or whatever. Yeah,
Intouchables.
Yeah. Intouchables. Yeah.
Yeah.
Which I've heard great things about. Actually, I haven't seen it, but I've heard very good things about it.
Well, all my French friends love it.
Oui?
I
c'est bon.
Yeah. Well, I saw it with an audience of Tuesday critique du cinéma, and nobody laughed. Anyway, because the subtitles aren't funny, but evidently the picture's a riot in French and they couldn't translate it.
Actually, it's the highest grossing or second highest grossing film ever in French history, apparently.
In world history at this point, if you ask Harvey. Yeah. I think that's going to win over the really depressing film about death. But they're going to nominate Emmanuel Riva, and then you have the interesting problem of having Marion Cotillard, who's French, in a French film, legless.
Yeah.
The whale bites off her legs, and that's the story of that movie. So she's a paraplegic. And you have an Emmanuel Riva also playing somebody with this extreme disability. Another French film.
That's always the joke. I mean, you play a disabled character, and that'll get you an Oscar nomination.
So. There's so many of them this year.
Yeah.
It's just formidable, overwhelming. So it's just, and will Beasts of the Southern Wild, because SAG banned it, get into anything?
Right, yeah.
You know, will they push it this thing?
But every year there's always one film at SAG that's disqualified because of union rules or something like that. I mean, last year wasn't.
Well, this is
last
a small year was, indie that really needs it.
Yeah.
It needed that support because that little girl, Quvenzhané Wallace, is just a genius, and she.
I know SAG's important in terms of helping out the film, but I don't think it's essential. I mean, I think as long as the Oscar voters see Beasts of the Southern Wild, and I think Beasts of the Southern Wild, because it was released so early and it was the only film that really got so much buzz in the summer months, I think a lot of people will look to it, check out their screeners that they haven't seen already. Kind of, I've heard, you know, there are about 2 months or so where that was the only film that was kind of being touted as an Oscar nominee. So I think it'll help them out.
Except that SAG overlaps with the actors branch in the Academy, actors branch.
Actors have a lot of pull.
Takes something like a SAG disqualification very seriously. Very seriously. And malheureusement, as the French would say, but I love Quvenzhané, and she's the only one I've had on my show. Well, except Keira Knightley, of course, the other nominee.
She was on
my show at Toronto, and she said, you should change your line to, I mean, I said, maybe have a Fabulous, and she said, no, get a Holt on. And on that note, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to say goodbye from Comic-Con and Anthony Del Call, just out of television lockdown in Toronto. They set him free to come on the Stephen Holt Show. Don't know what it was, but it was intense.
And I told them I have to go on to the Stephen Holt Show, and they said yes.
I'm so
you're
glad
allowed
you
to
did.
Go.
Thank you so much.
Well, thank you, Steve. It's great
to
see
in
you
here today.
And you make that shirt look so much better.
Yes, it makes me look thinner, believe it or not. Anyway, well, I'll say what Kara said. Get a Holt on.